I didn't wake you up. I just came home and was wondering if everything worked out all right.
Hi, Steve. Yes, we made the deadline.
Oh, that's awesome. I feel so bad you couldn't make it.
Hope you guys had a nice Labor Day party.
Oh, yes. I mean, the band was great, and Mike fell in the pool. Oh, and then Roy got really sick. No, wait, Brian. And then he fell in the pool, too. No, Roy. Wait. Ah, well, I'll tell you all about it at work tomorrow afternoon.
I won't be there for 2 weeks, remember?
Oh, wait, yeah, but, do you really have to? 2 weeks is a lifetime.
Yeah, Steve, I really have to. But I will continue testing for Addit.
Oh, okay, right, awesome.
You know, I better get some sleep now. My plane leaves early in the morning.
Okay, Meredith, have a wonderful flight. I'll talk to you soon.
Thanks so much for picking me up, Mr. Coleman.
Mr. Coleman? Please, just call me Frank. We're colleagues now, after all.
Well, okay, Frank. Thanks so much for making time for me on Labor Day.
No problem, Meredith. Postal workers always have each other's back. Your dad helped me dozens of times whenever I was in a bit of pickle.
Well, I hope I can fill his shoes. He hardly ever missed a day.
I'm sure you'll do great. You know what? While we're en route, why don't we deliver some mail in our beautiful little lake town?
And show me the ropes? Sure.
All right, then. Get ready to roll.
Always more beautiful than I remember it.
I don't think I'll ever get tired of driving around it. And there's our first stop.
Okay, sir, what's the plan?
Delivering mail is like a walk in the park with mailboxes. Take this bag, walk to the mailbox, and insert the mail. Just take your time, Miss Weiss. They never start a game until Frank Coleman has turned on his TV. You know what I really like about watching baseball? Not missing the first pitch. Take your time, Miss Weiss. They never start a game until Frank Coleman has turned on his TV. You know what I really like about watching baseball? Not missing the first pitch. Take your time, Miss Weiss. They never start a game until Frank Coleman has turned on his TV. You know what I really like about watching baseball? Not missing the first pitch. Take your time, Miss Weiss. They never start a game until Frank Coleman has turned on his TV. You know what I really like about watching baseball? Not missing the first pitch. Take your time, Miss Weiss. They never start a game until Frank Coleman has turned on his TV. Nothing too difficult, right?
I think I should be able to face the challenge.
I bet. Didn't you go to MIT?
Yeah. I left here for Massachusetts 22 years ago.
Shouldn't you get a job in computers then? That's really booming right now.
Well, actually,
Hold that thought. We just arrived at our next address. It's a package this time, so you'll have to get it out of the back.
No answer. That's the last of them.
You're getting the hang of it. So, where were we? Computers. Should I buy one?
Well, it depends on what you want to use it for.
Bookkeeping. I always make a mess of my tax returns. Can't a computer do that for me?
Sure, there are programs for that, but you'll still have to put in some work yourself.
I was afraid you were going to say that. I'll bug you about it another time. Our next address is right around the corner.
There's no place like home.
Sure isn't. Can't wait to get home either. The Mets are playing the Giants.
Oh, before I get out, what time do I start tomorrow?
7 a.m. sharp. Just check in at the post office.
Okay, Frank. See you tomorrow.
Adios.
Hi, Meredith. I just wanted to let you know that Dad and I landed safely. The Florida weather is all they said it would be. I'll call again soon. Oh, one more thing. The freezer's stuffed with food, and there's blueberry pie in the fridge. Bye.
Meredith, it's Steve. I didn't get the chance to say it earlier, but thanks so much for being a trooper. I know you had other plans for Labor Day weekend, but nailing the deadline for Ad at 87 could very well be the most important milestone in our company's history. Enjoy your well-deserved time off. Don't get too used to it. Just kidding. Or am I? I'll talk to you later.
Good morning, Meredith. Ready for your first day?
Good morning, Frank. Ready to rock.
It's a great day to be on the road. I already filled up the mailbag in the truck, so you're good to go. Oh, I forgot to tell you. There's a map in the cabin, in case you get lost.
Thanks, I'll probably need that.
Bon voyage!
Can I help you?
Hello. Here's today's mail.
New in town. Your face looks familiar.
Well, I grew up here and then left for college 22 years ago.
22 years ago, back when they called me Nancy Sinatra instead of Nancy Reagan. So now you're back, huh? I know what it's like.
You do?
It's best not to feel bad about it. Only a few people ever really make it. I wonder if it's gonna rain today. It's been raining a lot lately.
Fire breath and open sky.
There's Stan's Diner. Wait, it's called Moe's Diner now?
Meredith Wise? As I live and breathe. Come here, hon. Now, let me look at you. My, oh my. A few lines here and there, and the occasional gray hair. But my gosh, it's you, all right.
Wow, Maureen, long time no see. I feel so old.
Oh, don't be like that now. It suits you. Age only makes a person more distinguished, is what I always say. To the mirror. Now come here. Tell me everything.
But, Maureen, I do have work to do.
I know you're busy, hon. Little Bird told me all about your temporary mail job already. News goes around pretty quickly around here. So, coffee? Something stronger? I warn you, I will not take no for an answer.
It's like I'm 17 again, Maureen.
In that case, you're welcome, honey. Two coffee coming right up. And one piece of blueberry pie, if I remember correctly. You had one almost every afternoon after school at one point.
Oh, you know me too well, Maureen.
Always have, always will. Ashley, one blueberry pie. And Ashley, could you keep an eye on the bar for me for a bit? I'm gonna take my break now. You're a real trooper. Ashley? Oh, sweet Mary. What are you doing? Is everything okay, hon? Oh, Lord have mercy.
Maybe you should check that out.
Honestly! First the roof and now this? Ugh, that poor kid is like a disaster magnet. I'm sorry, Meredith. Looks like I've got my hands full for a bit. Next time, I want to hear everything, you hear? Don't be a stranger now.
Actually enjoying this. Ah, the mighty Ambrose River. In a few days, I won't even need that map. Hi there. I've got some mail for this address.
You're not Frank.
I'm Meredith Weiss. I'll be delivering your mail for a while.
And Frank just gave you the keys to the goose?
The goose?
Yes. Your white and wobbly van, duh. I'm Lori. I'm Providence Oaks' mechanic. And I'm the one who keeps the goose running.
Well, Thomas is my father. Does that count?
Thomas! Yes, that surely counts. My father has been teaching me since the day I was born. There is no one better in PO than me. And I have to get back to work now. But I suppose you may drive the goose. On one condition. If there's ever anything wrong with it, you bring it back to me, yes?
Well, I don't have much of a choice, do I?
Nope. Did Frank tell you about the radio?
No.
It currently only receives the local station. Plus, sometimes it cuts out altogether. If that happens, just give it a big old bang on the dashboard and that should fix it right up. I'm working on it, I promise.
Okay. Thanks, Lori.
No problem, Miss W.
Where was Bear Creek again? right, Bear Creek, near the old lumberyard.
There's a new face.
Yes, indeed. As of today, I'll be delivering the mail.
Great. I'm Robert. Nice to meet you.
Likewise. I'm Meredith. And here's your mail.
Thanks. I'd better open this right away. Oh, what the...
That doesn't sound good.
Crap. That's what it sounds like. Bullcrap. Freshly baked bullcrap.
Hey, the sound can't be worse than the smell.
I'm sorry, but I have to take a better look at this. Have a nice day.
Well, hello there, big cuddly guy.
Oh, look, Genevieve, a new mailman. Hello there. What's your name, then?
Hi, Miss Jenkins, right? I'm Meredith. Meredith Weiss?
Weiss, of course. You're Emily's girl, aren't you? This is Meryl Weiss, Genevieve. She used to live in town years and years ago.
Years to be exact, but who's counting?
Has it been that long? That's almost two Genevieves ago. Calm down, Genevieve. You're going to live forever. She isn't, but shh. You do remember me, don't you?
How could I forget Miss Mildred Jenkins? And her cats, of course. Seems like they've multiplied.
Yes, I do like cats. Is that such a crime? So what if I have slightly more of them than I used to? Like Genevieve here, and Thomas, and Oliver. Anyway, did you have a package for me then?
Yes, here you go.
Ah, thank you, dear. Looks like another gift from my son. Still doing everything to get into my good graces, except actually drop by.
I'm sure he means well. He's probably just busy.
That's what he says. That's probably what you say to poor Emily, too. Anyway, I won't keep you any longer. Run along, dear. Give Emily my best.
Goodbye, Miss Jenkins. Genevieve. Interesting. That's the last of them. Hello?
Hi, Meredith. It's Mom. How are you? How's the job?
Hi, Mom. I'm all right. The job's okay, I guess. It's not the most exciting thing I've ever done.
Oh, I'm sure you'll be fine. It's only for 2 weeks. Dad drove that truck for decades.
Yeah, I can't complain. And you? Enjoying yourself over there?
I'm doing great. I'm reading lots of books in the sun. I also went on a beach walk, and I saw baby turtles hatch. Oh, I'm almost out of coins. I'm calling from a bar, and Dad's ordering a margarita again. Talk soon.
Let's see what's on TV tonight.
Previously on Bon Appetit.
Has anyone seen Henri?
Yeah, he's in the kitchen, unpacking the new tableware.
Henri! Did someone call me?
We're starting the day as we always do, with a P.O. positive or pet peeve, followed by the weather.
P.O. positive or pet peeve?
Dale, what's it gonna be?
It's a positive all the way, Jack. I went to Moe's Diner yesterday, and I don't think I've ever had blueberry pie that tasted so good.
Mm-hmm. Thank you much, Dale. That makes me want to get a piece right now. But the weather's first. We'll start off sunny with a few clouds later today. How about some music now?
sir. Parcel for you. I hope I'm not disturbing, but here's a parcel for you.
1 minute, I'm busy.
Okay, sir.
Is that a parcel for me?
Yes, sir. Oregon Trail Motel.
You can just put it on the counter.
You're welcome.
dear. So glad you could come by. Oh, it's quite the emergency.
What's wrong, Miss Jenkins?
It's poor little Mortimer. He's fallen ill, I think. One minute he was full of life. The next he, well, he just wasn't.
I mean, I'm not a vet, but he looks fine to me.
Well, fact is, you're not a vet, are you? You know who knows about animals, though? Is Mr. Mackey. He runs the old bait shop by the lake. Could you take Mortimer to him?
Sure, I'll get right on it. Here, little kitty, come on.
Wonderful! Be nice to Meredith, Mortimer. Don't shed too much hair in her van now.
Bye, Miss Jenkins.
Bye, Meredith. See you soon, Mortimer.
Hey, Mom and Dad have new neighbors. Siegler, huh? Don't think they ever mentioned them. Mr. Mackey, I know you're closed, but...
What?
I'm Meredith Weiss.
Yeah, Meredith Weiss. Thomas, kid. I remember you running around the lake when you were yay high, getting into all sorts of trouble. What can I do you for?
Mildred Jenkins tells me you know a lot about animals, and, well...
Oh, hi there, little fellow. What's your name?
Apparently it's Mortimer.
Well, pleased to meet you, Mort. He's a little sluggish. Has Millie been feeding him cupcakes again?
To be honest, I have no idea.
Leave him with me. I'll put him on a diet today. Maybe even catch him a fish if they're bite. With any luck, he should be up and running in the morning.
Thank you, sir. By the way, how are you?
I'm fine. You go back to running around that lake, Miss Weiss.
Okay. Bye, Mr. Mackey. Bye, Mortimer. Same handwriting as the one I delivered next door. I'm guessing party invitations?
Welcome to the Flick Shack. How can I help you?
Got a package for you, ma'am.
Hold on. You're our new postal worker? Talk about not looking the part.
Is that a compliment?
Trust me, it definitely is.
Well, thank you then. Name's Meredith, by the way. Meredith Weiss.
Angie, Eastman. So, what brings you to Providence Oaks?
Grew up here, and now I'm back to do my dad a favor.
Ah, I myself have been here for 6 years.
And what brings you here?
Didn't grow up here, came to do myself a favor.
Touché, Mrs. Eastman.
Miss.
So, how's business?
It's booming. People in Providence Oaks sure like their movies. I guess it's because there's not much else to do around here. Might as well watch a flick, right?
Well, other than enjoy the scenery.
Scenery schmeary. Why stare at a boring lake when you can go to outer space and watch the Death Star get blown up?
Maybe I should watch more movies. Well, it was nice meeting you, Miss Eastman.
Call me Angie. And here, someone just returned this, and it should be right up your alley.
The postman always rings twice? My kind of humor.
Well, I don't know anything else about you, Mrs. Temporary Postal Worker.
Miss. But touche, Angie. All right. I'll check it out if I have the time.
Take your time. This isn't exactly the most popular flick in the shack. And there's plenty of choice, regardless.
Okay. Well, it was nice meeting you, Miss Angie.
Same here, Miss Meredith.
Commander Grace, we have established communication with ground control. How do you wish to proceed?
Tell them we landed the rocket!
Ground control, we have landed the rocket! We will now begin our experiments!
Package for the Evans family?
Just a minute! Commander Grace, permission to explore?
Permission granted!
Yep, we're the Evans family. Could I just take that real quick? I'm kind of in the middle of a lunar landing.
Sure. Here you go. Nice helmet, by the way.
Why, thank you. I actually modeled it on the Apollo 11 crew outfit. Wait. What? Meredith?
Guilty as charged. I'm sorry. Who are you?
What? For real? You don't recognize your old best friend when you see her?
Wait a minute. Kay?
Great. And now I busted my colander. I knew opening the door in this thing was a bad idea.
I'm sorry. I didn't recognize you with the colander thing. The helmet.
Yeah, clearly. But it seems I'm not the only one who came in disguise.
Got me there. You're Kay Evans now?
Don't sound so surprised. But yes, I married Barry Evans. I'm sure you remember our high school star quarterback.
Mom!
Be right there, Commander Grace! Scanning for alien life forms. That's my little scientist back there. She's crazy about space travel, as you may have guessed, even after the whole Challenger thing.
Sounds like you're doing great. I'm happy for you.
Well, obviously a lot can happen in 22 years, so...
Time flies.
So, I heard you were back in town for a while. From Maureen.
That's right. I ran into her yesterday at the diner. Your Uncle Stan wasn't there, unfortunately. I must have just missed him.
Nope. It's Moe's diner now. Like I said, a lot of things happened while you were away. Also, I work there now. At the diner.
That's great. Maybe I'll drop by sometime.
Yeah, we'll see.
Ready for a liftoff!
Listen, I'm sorry, but I don't really have time for this right now. Can't get stuck on the moon on my own, and I have to get ready for work. See you around, Em.
Good to see you, Kay. Evans!
Commander Grace, hold up! You'll never guess what I just found.
You can say that again.
Meredith, hi.
Oh, hi, Steve. How are you?
Busy as two peas. Added 87 is really getting there. Hey, listen, you've got plenty of time, right?
I guess, but that's nice for a change.
Awesome, I need a favor. I sent a bunch of files your way. It's the retail pitch for Added 87. It's good, but not great. It needs your magic. Do you think you can add it?
I'm not sure. How many pages are we talking about here?
It's not much. It's just the pitch, and there's also an instruction book. Can't be more than 100 pages. I could just send it to your post office, right?
I guess.
Awesome. Mail back to me as soon as possible. Priority mail. Thanks so much. Oh, I gotta run.
Okay, Steve.
Oh, one final thing. Now let this marinate. Add it, 87, add anything you like. It's fancy, right? Yeah, don't tell me now. I got a jet. Bye.
All right, well, let's watch this. Oh, Steve's parcel, and a note from Tess. Hey, Em, hope you're doing well. Steve told me you'd want to read through this monstrosity. Not sure if you really said that, but have a great time there anyways. Take care. Tess.
See what it is today. The floor is yours, Angie.
Good morning, Jack. I've got a...
And now on to today's weather. We can enjoy the sun in the morning, but the clouds will cover it more and more. Enough talking. Here are some tunes.
There's a face I
Good
remember.
Morning, Mr. Harris.
Hey there. More paperwork with my name on it?
Well, take a look for yourself.
Thanks. Oh, it gets worse every day.
More bullcrap?
Can you believe it? I've been taking care of this lakeside for years, and now they're gonna bulldoze it and build apartments.
Oh, that's a shame. I'd hate to see the place I grew up ruined by an apartment building.
What? You grew up here?
Yes, my father was the mailman before me.
Mr. Weiss. Ah, so you're the prodigy he's always talking about.
Wouldn't surprise me. But tell me about that paperwork.
They say you can file an official objection, but I'm not a great match with bureaucracy. I'd rather get the chainsaw and cut down town hall.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Easy now.
Just kidding. It's a nice thought, though.
Well? Maybe I can help out. I'm better with paper than chainsaws.
Would you? Awesome. I'll think about it. Have a great day.
Good day, Mr. Harris.
Hey, wait up. I'm done thinking about it. Maybe you'd want to go through all the files together tomorrow afternoon at Moe's. Food and drinks on me.
That didn't take you long.
Yeah, sorry. I blurted that out. But it's still a good plan, though.
Okay, sure. Tomorrow afternoon at Moe's.
Great. I'll make sure to bring all the files, and I'll see you there.
earth do these folks order? Hi, Maureen.
Hi, hon. How are you doing this fine day?
I'm fine, but how are you? You know, with the kitchen exploding?
Oh, that? Nothing a fresh lick of paint and a mop couldn't fix. Didn't mean to scare you. Let's pick up where we left off, shall we? And one piece of blueberry pie. Ashley, one blueberry pie. Meredith Wise, back in Providence Oaks. How's life treating you, darling?
It's all right, actually. I delivered a package to Kay at her house earlier.
Yeah, she told me. How did that go for you?
I think I put my foot in it, to tell you the truth.
I can imagine it can be a lot to take in for the both of you. Especially after being away for so long. Then again, there are some things that never change, right?
Well, this diner sure did.
Glad you noticed.
Even the name changed.
Yeah, I decided it was time for a change. Didn't feel the same after my Stan died. World keeps turning. Gotta keep moving along with it, right?
Oh my gosh, Maureen. Stan died? I'm so sorry. I had no idea.
Thank you, darling. But it's really okay. It's been 10 years already. 10 and a half, almost. Oh, boy, did I love that man. We've been married for so long. It hit me like a brick. But after a while, I decided that sadness wasn't the only emotion I was allowed to have. That's not what Stan would have wanted either.
Sounds like you went through a lot.
Thank you, hon. I do appreciate that. Anyway, you have to get back up. So I did. For me, but also for Kay. She took her uncle's death pretty hard.
I wish I'd known.
Sorry for dumping all that on you like that, darling. Gosh, look at your face. I'm a bit surprised you didn't know. Didn't your parents tell you about it? Or Kay?
I can't recall.
Oh, it's okay, hon. I honestly don't give a hoot about any blame game. We all have our lives to live, but Kay's been through a lot. Nursed her uncle through his illness, helping me out. I think seeing you again shook her up a little, was all. She must have missed you during those days.
I can imagine. It was good to see her again. I've missed her too.
Then, it sounds like you know what to do. Listen, Meredith. Time marches on. And eventually, you realize it's marching across your face. Life's too short. That's exactly why I decided this place could do with a repurpose after Stan passed. Fresh start. It's been Moe's Diner ever since. And believe it or not, business is better than ever.
That's great to hear, Maureen. Congratulations.
Why, thank you kindly. And listen, you check in with me and Kay again soon, you hear? Don't forget about what's important in life.
Hand on my heart, I will return as soon as I have a delivery. Or sooner.
I'll hold you to that.
You bet. Bye, Maureen. there, Mr. Mackey. How's Mortimer?
Oh, good day, Meredith. Mort's fine, as I expected. It was just a little indigest. Good night's rest and a bit of lake trout in the morning has done the little critter a world of good.
Excellent. Miss Jenkins will be pleased. Let me take him off your hands.
All right. Bye, Mort. Anything else, Miss Weiss? Enjoying yourself so far?
I'm having fun, yes.
Well, that's good. I'm guessing I'll see you around a lot more, Miss Weiss.
For sure, Mr. Mackey. Have a nice day. No answer. There you go. Look who's back.
Oh, look at you. You're good as new.
Yeah, Mr. Mackey did say not to feed him cupcakes.
I suppose he's right. It's just that he likes them so much. Don't you, Mortimer? Anyway, thank you so much, Meredith.
My pleasure. See you, Miss Jenkins.
Call me Mildred, dear. Say goodbye to Meredith, Mortimer.
What on earth do these folks order?
Oh, hello again. More mail for me?
And the tape you gave me.
Oh, wow. You watched it already?
A drifter in a sleepy town, an affair, and a plot to kill a husband? There's a lot more to this movie than I expected.
It's a classic, and probably my favorite noir. They did a remake a couple years back, but it's, well, it's not as good. You can't beat Lana Turner's smoldering intensity.
Yeah, she's great in it.
I'm so glad you like. Most of the people here don't really appreciate the art of classic cinema. They just want to see Police Academy again.
I'm afraid you're right.
Pretty lonely, being the only movie buff around.
Well, keep feeding my VCR and I'll be up to speed in no time.
Will do. Let me think about it and I'll get back to you. You know, it's good to see you.
That's nice to hear.
Because I have a sneaky little plan.
Oh, we're whispering now?
I want you to meet me, say, at 5 today.
Is that the plan?
No, but it's where I'll discuss the plan. You in?
Sorry, Angie, but I really can't.
Boring. Some other time, then.
Maybe. Later.
Open up the window. I'm
I'm calling it a day. Hello?
Hey, Meredith.
Hey, Dad! How's life? I heard something about poker, fishing, and margaritas.
Talk to Mom, huh? But yeah, can't complain. How about you? Do you like my job?
I'm starting to love it. Being on the road, the freedom, the people.
That's great to hear. Frank's quite the character, huh?
Frank's quite the character indeed. He said you helped him out once.
More than once. Well, what can I say? He likes baseball a bit too much. He places a bet every now and then. Nothing too serious.
And what about Mildred Jenkins?
Mildred likes to talk a lot. I sometimes postpone delivering her mail until she and her cats can't ambush me. Speaking of ambushes, your mom is telling me to hurry up. We're going to a movie.
Okay, Dad, don't keep her waiting. What movie?
Stand By Me. About four Oregon boys in the 50s. Right up my alley.
Sounds good. Say hi to Mom for me.
Will do. Bye, Meredith.
Right, here we go. earth did these folks order? Hi, Lori. Got some mail for you today.
Oh, hi, Miss W. Yeah, thanks.
Something on your mind?
Oh, it's nothing. Don't worry about it.
Are you sure? You seem out of it.
It's just... Angie came by with a movie box and a couple of movies to watch. The Love Bug and A Nightmare on Elm Street.
Oh, did she? I'm not surprised. And you're having trouble picking?
Ugh, I don't. But if my parents catch me watching Elm Street, they'll ground me for a week. I wish they'd just take a chill pill and see that I'm basically an adult. I fix cars.
Oh, no, that's too bad, Lori. Maybe you can watch it at a friend's house instead.
No, I'm homeschooled. There aren't many teenagers here, as you may have noticed. So I don't really have any friends to watch it with. So it's a Love Bug for me.
Tell you what, take the Love Bug now and we'll watch the horror movie at my place. Would Sunday work for you?
What? Really? Yes, it would. That'd be wicked, Miss W.
Of course. I'm always in for a good fright. So, see you Sunday?
Totally. Thanks so much.
Deal. Have a nice day. Hi, Kay. Delivery for the diner.
Hey, Meredith. Sure. Just, put it on the counter, would you?
Kay, about the other day.
What about it?
I really put my foot in it.
Maybe it wasn't the best time for that conversation.
Maybe not.
Yeah.
So... I talked to Maureen.
Let me guess. You got a piece of Maureen's wisdom too, eh? Why doesn't that surprise me? That explains why she wanted me to take over today's shift, then.
She told me about Uncle Stan. I'm so sorry.
Thanks. It was a long time ago, but I appreciate it. It's not the same without him.
Sorry I wasn't there. For you and Maureen.
That's kind of you to say, Meredith. I mean, I didn't contact you about it at the time, but then again, I had kind of given up by then.
I guess everyone has their own things to deal with, even me.
I get it. There's always a reason for things to go the way they do.
Even so, it never seems to be the right rate. Time marches on. What did Maureen always say about that again?
One day you realize...
It's marching across your face.
Oh, Mo. Some things never change.
Didn't she steal that line from somewhere anyway?
Yep. Yeah. Hey, Em. It was good to talk, I mean. You know.
Yeah, it was.
I have to get back to it, but see you around, maybe?
I'm sure. See ya. Hello, sir.
I reckon that's a parcel with my name on it.
I reckon your name is Jack Reynolds?
Indeed I am. And I reckon you're the new postal worker?
I reckon you could say that.
Well, thank you much. New around here, I reckon. People call me JR. I'm a farmer and DJ.
I'm Meredith. Nice to meet you. DJ and farmer? That's a rare combo.
Indeed it is. But it's a nice distraction from farmer. I've seen better times. I had some spare time and a room in the shed, so I figured, why not?
About your playlist. It's really nice.
Thanks. But I really need to add more songs. But I'm in the middle of a potato harvest. Don't have much time. Hey, listen. Postal worker Meredith, I need to get back to work. Can you do me a favor and give this envelope to Frank?
Sure, no problem.
Thank you so much.
Interesting. These look like bills.
earth do these folks order? Here's the mail, ma'am.
One of those.
Well now, Meredith and Robert, welcome to Moe's. Table for two.
Hi, Maureen. Yes, please. A quiet one, if possible. We've got work to do.
Is that what they're calling it now? Speaking of work, Robert, someone reckon they could fix the roof themselves and, made it worse somehow. I mean, foot just went right through. No physical harm, thankfully.
The roof, yes. I promise to take a look at it. Let me check out the damage real quick. Be right back.
Thanks, darling. Sure is one of the good ones right there.
He seems very nice, but I haven't actually talked to him longer than 10 minutes.
What's time got to do with anything? You know what you want when you see it, hon.
Haha, Maureen. Speak for yourself.
Well, I guess there might be a bit of projection involved. Well, who can blame me, right? Anyway, let me show you to my nicest table. I hear the sun hits your face in all the right places here.
Okay, so what you're saying is there's a couple of things but no chainsaws.
Definitely no chainsaws, for the moment. It's just that the remaining options will take time, effort, and patience.
Well, that's one out of three for me.
Can I get you lovebirds? Anything else?
Maureen, really? I could always decide not to fix your roof today, you know.
Don't worry, Robert. I know Maureen. I'm sure she doesn't mean anything by it. A coffee refill would be nice. Thanks, Maureen.
Gotcha, hon. Robert?
The same for me, please.
Sure thing. Back in a jiff.
Ashley, is that coffee machine still running? They what?
Glad we're finally done for today. But there's more to come.
I'm sure you'll do fine.
Thanks, but you don't sound very convincing.
To be honest, you probably need some extra help.
Is that an offer?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, you two hard-working individuals, here you go.
Thanks, Maureen. More coffee. How could anyone survive without it? So, how's life in PO so far?
It's only been a week, but so far, so good.
Yeah, I've been here a bit longer. Time sure does fly.
I'm sure you must have some good stories.
Yeah, look, Meredith, I'm sorry. I really better get started on fixing that roof. It's just, that's quite a big job. While it's still light out and all, you know. So, thanks so much for your help. I mean, I really do appreciate it. Drive home safe. I'll see you around town. So, yeah, I'll see you.
Everything okay over here?
Yeah, I guess. I'm not sure.
Good day. My name is Walter Morgan. I'm from the Postal Service. I'm calling with regards to compliance to policies and guidelines, such as the use of Postal Service property, code of conduct, and so on. I will be in touch again soon.
Meredith, it's Steve.
What's up, Steve?
Thanks so much for improving the text and sending it back to me. I'm confident this will improve our chances of securing a monster deal.
You're welcome, Steve. A monster deal?
It's a monster deal. The big retailer, big money, big prizes.
A monster deal? That is so awesome! Big money, big prizes! Whew, I need to calm down too.
Well, yes, calmness is needed. Eyes on the prize. The next steps are me going to meet up with them this week. Discuss terms.
Eye of the tiger. Go get him, Steve.
Thanks, Meredith. Speak soon.